Hey guys, I'm Brett Williams from BretFX.com. And in this tutorial, we're going to take a look at using Final Cut Pro's built-in draw mask to create a really cool title reveal, like you see playing on the screen right here.
This is a great effect that you see everywhere. It's nice and organic, simple, clean, and you can do it right in Final Cut Pro, no plugins required. All right, so we're going to use three layers to create this effect. The bottom layer is our surfer walking. The middle layer is our fictional logo, Sunrise Surfboards. I hope there's not a real Sunrise Surfboards out there. And the top layer is our surfer clip again with the animated draw mask applied to reveal the logo as he walks by. Some people prefer to apply the mask directly to the logo layer, but I like to sandwich the logo between the foreground, our surfer, and the background, the ocean. To me, it just makes a little bit more sense, sort of a foreground to background kind of thing. All right, so all that said, let's jump in and get started. I'm going to delete the top layer so that we're starting with just our video clip and the logo that we want to reveal. So first, let's place a duplicate of the background clip above the logo by holding Option and dragging it up. Now let's open up the effects browser and find the draw mask effect. It's in the mask category, and we'll drag it over to our top layer. I'm going to go ahead and close the effects browser. All right, now we see right here it says click to add a control point. It wants me to start drawing my mask. But first, I'm going to go ahead and press V to turn off the top layer so I can move the playhead to right before our title is going to start to reveal from behind our surfer. Before we start drawing our mask, just remember, we only need to be precise in the area around our surfer right where the logo is, about from his neck to his waist. So now with the top layer still selected, I'm going to press V again to turn the layer back on and leave my playhead right where it is. You may want to scale back the viewer window up here to, 50% or something so you can see a little bit of the canvas behind it. I can see enough here even at 100%, so I think we'll be okay. So I'm going to click outside the viewer up here at the top to start, and then click another control point at his head. I'm going to go around his back and around the surfboard. I'll try to be fairly precise, but it's okay if it's not perfect. We can adjust and feather our mask later. And now I'm going to click kind of below the viewer here and then over to the lower right and then over to the upper right. And then we're going to click back on our original point to close and complete the mask. All right, so we're going to need to adjust this mask with keyframes as he walks by. So over in the inspector, let's twirl open the transform controls and also the control points control so you can see exactly what's going on. Now, if you don't have your inspector set to a full height like this, all you have to do is double click up here in the top and it'll give you a full height. So the transform controls moves the entire mask as a whole. If you click in the middle of the mask in the viewer and drag it around, you'll see that the control points don't move at all, but you'll see that the position X and Y moves. And by the same means, if you change the individual control points, it changes the shape of the mask. You can select them individually, or you can draw sort of a marquee lasso around them and select multiple at a time. I'm going to undo both of those. For this exercise, we're going to keyframe both the control points and the transform controls to achieve our goal. Let's go ahead and set a keyframe for the position control. Even if you only plan to animate the control points, this is still a good idea, just in case. And let's set a keyframe for the control points. You can only keyframe the control points as a whole shape, not the individual points themselves. All right, so now that we've set our first keyframe, let's advance the playhead about 6 frames down the timeline. I'm just pressing the right arrow key on the keyboard. And we'll adjust our mask. First, I'll click inside the mask and move it to the right and line it up the best I can with our surfer. Then I'll tweak the individual control points to adjust for his motion. Now over in the inspector, you can see it automatically added keyframes for position and control points. Once you've turned on keyframes by setting the first one, any adjustments you make will create additional keyframes. I'm going to advance the playhead forward again, another 6 frames. and adjust the mask position and tweak the control points again. And you can see we're just starting to see a little bit of our logo reveal right here, that part, a little bit of the S coming out. All right, so real quick here, I'm going to keep advancing forward and adjusting the mask until we've revealed our entire logo, and maybe then a little bit more just for good measure. You can see all the adjustments reflected in the inspector as we go along. By the way, 6 frames is just kind of an arbitrary number. You might get away with more or less, but we can always go back and add keyframes and adjustments later. All right, so now that we've finished, let's take a look and see how we've done. That's pretty good, but I think we need to make a little adjustment back here. So if you have a couple frames or an area that needs to be fixed, just navigate to the problem area, adjust your control points, your mask, your position, and the keyframes will be added automatically. Okay, now that we're happy with our mask, or a little happier with our mask, let's add a little bit of feather just to soften it up a bit. If you need to, you can click the little pen icon up here in the top of the draw mask layer to turn the mask off in the viewer so that you can better see what's going on. I think about, 1 to 5, 6 pixels makes for a nice soft edge. It just kind of cleans things up a bit. All right, let's hit play. And so that's it. Super cool, super organic text reveal right inside Final Cut Pro 10. No need for motion or any special plugins. If you find these kinds of tutorials useful, please check out my channel, BretFX, and check out my web store, BretFX.com, where you'll find lots of free Final Cut Pro 10 plugins you can download and more. Thanks again for tuning in. Have a great day, and happy editing.